shaking cold. These hands are meant to hold.
Everybody, and welcome to Reads Reads. I'm your host, Ryan Reed, creator and webmaster of Spider Girls World, Rockin' Raccoon, and of course, Baron Zemo Files. We'll get a little bit to the Zemo Files a little later. Well, it's a new week, and I got a lot to talk about here, so let's get on with the review, shall we? Got two great books this week. We got Thunderstrike number 4. Yes, we're almost to the end. And Fear Itself, Book of the Skull, Prelude. That's right. Fear Itself is about to sweep the Marvel Universe. What's the story about? We'll get into that next. But first, let's do a little bit of Thunderstrike, shall we? Thunderstrike 4 picks up where last issue left off, with Kevin Masterson severely injured after his attack by Adam Mann. Luckily, thanks to the enchanted powers of the Thunderstrike, Kevin recovers back to his human body. However, Adam quickly learns that he's really Thunderstrike. However, quickly Kevin reclaims the Thunderstrike and fights back against Adam Mann and gets the upper hand and defeats him. Unfortunately, that's when Mangog, everybody's favorite Thor villain, breaks through the catastrophe, ends up eating Adam Mann due to his powers, and then goes after New York. However, Kevin decides to let bygones be bygones and ends up calling upon Steve Rogers and the rest of the Avengers to fight Mangog, saying that his name is Thunderstrike and he brought along a lot of friends. I really enjoyed this issue. Thunderstrike 4, I mean, I think the best part is with Kevin Masterson. I mean, he's gone from this angry kind of high schooler who just hated everything, hated every superheroes over what happened to his father. And now he's kind of seeing it's a hard business. And now that he's actually been given the gift and the responsibility, he's not only accepting it, but he's also deciding to take amends with the Avengers, who he blames for the death of his father. The series is really good. I was a little surprised how Adam Mann's storyline got ended, but, you know, there's one issue to go. For all we know, once Mangog is defeated, which is hopefully what's going to happen, Adam Mann might come back after being eaten by the character. But we should see, and I'm looking really forward to what's going to happen with Kevin and Thor. I'm going to give this review 4.5 stars. It was a great issue. I think the revelation with Kevin coming to the fact that superhero is a hard business was a little too quick, maybe. I mean, if they would have had another issue, I could understand. But you know what? It was a great book. Tom DeFalco did a wonderful job with writing. Ron Frenz's artwork is fantastic, especially his battle scenes between Thunderstrike and Adam Mann, and, of course, the coming of Mangog, showing just how powerful he is. And I also like the new Thunderstrike costume. It's actually kind of cool. It's a little, I'll let you decide on that one. I'll tell you what our cartoon is some other time. Well, with that all finished, let's move on, shall we, to Fear Itself Prelude, Book of the Skull. And yes, if you're really interested, you can also pick up the sketchbook here, Fear Itself, which goes great in packet in 1 and 2. That's right, I am a salesman after all, everyone. Shall we get to it? The Skull takes place as Sin, the daughter of the Red Skull, teams up with Baron Zemo to fulfill tasks for helping him attack Bucky earlier. It turns out back in 1942, the Nazis, including Baron von Strucker and the Red Skull, tried using some mystical elements to try to get an upper hand against the war. Ended up calling forth a demon, which ends up attacking the invaders. The invaders, of course, end up defeating the demon. How come it's revealed that there was actually a mystical hammer similar to Thor's that fell from the heavens, and that the Nazis built a secret base around him, and the book shows the location. Sin then quickly defeats and betrays Zemo and steals his ship and his supplies, leaving Zemo in the desert. And Zemo says that Sin hopes she ends up succeeding where her father failed, because he will not. I thought this book was pretty good. I mean, it was a little packed, but I understand here, since, you know, both Brubaker had a go with the prelude to what exactly is Fear Itself, how it's going to kick off with Sin, the daughter of the Red Skull, taking the mallet that was found and housed all these years after the Nazis left Germany. And I think it's a pretty cool little story. I think the best part is you really got to see the dynamics between Baron Zemo and Sin during the whole storyline, since Zemo is just cool. I mean, Ed Brubaker has never gotten Baron Zemo wrong. I mean, he still shows us exactly he has his own interests and he was just fulfilling a debt, but Sin still backstabbed in the end, and the fact he's left in the desert saying, "Hell, Sin, you better win here, because if you don't, I'm going to take care of you." That's Helmet Zemo, everybody. The artwork here was fantastic. I think Ramos Morales and Chow did a wonderful job on the work, giving the more darker and grittier feel of it. I love the Invader story, and it also kind of shows us why Bucky, you know, was great then and is pretty cool now as Captain America. But at the same time, it's kind of funny. And this is an in-joke here, but Captain America is never named in this entire issue. No Steve Rogers, not even by Rogers. And you know why? There's a little bit of an error. There's actually a joke on Tom Brevoort's Twitter that it got missed, and he feels kind of crazy about it. I understand, but it's really funny that Captain America is never named once, while all the other Invader characters are named, including Von Strucker too. So this is a great lead into Fear Itself. I'm looking forward to the main series, and I think it's going to be a really good story. I think Matt Fraction is going to really take off with it, so I'm going to give this issue a 4 even on stars here, because it was a really good story. It was a little padded, but I understand. It's a prelude issue, and it's also in a way for Brubaker to kind of say, well, I did this in Captain America, but you know, Fear Itself is not my storyline. That's Matt Fraction, and I'll just do my crossover and be done with it. So it worked really well, so it's a good series. Well, that's it for the books this week. I will give you a little bit of website information. The Baron Zemo Files. I'm just about to get ready to do a couple extra updates besides some images, but also Hawkeye's profile. We'll be getting on more of the Thunderbolts that he worked with during his tenures on the team. There's also going to be a little bit more coming up here with the animation hub here. I'm working with Earth's Mightiest Heroes to get some more of that done. And I should, hopefully, if things go well, start getting the Masters of Evil section up and running, but that won't be until later this summer. Rocket Raccoon is all updated here. Just update everything with Annihilators and Timely Incorporated. And if you don't believe me there, you can head over to comicvine.com. I just officially joined the group, and I'm having a lot of fun over there, so look for me over there. I'm known as Rad Reed over there on Comic Vine. It's right here at the bottom. See? There it is. Anywho, that's going to probably about do it for this week. First of all, a big shout out to my friends over at C2E2 in Chicago. Missing you guys. I can't be with you this year, but you know, unfortunately I can't. I gotta find a full-time job, and that's just what's eating up time, and I'm kind of mad that I'm not be able to go out there with all the cool stuff coming out with books this year and some other stuff coming up for graphic novels, as well as some novelists that are going to be there in Chicago. But you know, things happen. That's just how life is sometimes. You take with the good and take with the bad. So luckily Reads is still here to say. So that's going to be it for a couple weeks. I'll see you back here right on here. Good old YouTube. You can find me, of course, at Twitter at Avenger Files. That's Avenger Files, not plural. Avenger Files. Some people getting that mixed up, but that's true. You also can check me out over at Spider Girls World. I got a bunch of brand new sections coming up pretty soon, including, and here's the big announcement, everybody. I will be doing a sister site to Spider Girls World, which will be the Ultimate World of Peter Parker. That's right. You'll get everything you ever want to know about the Ultimate Spider-Man line, but we're afraid to ask. And this is just a recent thing because I've been able to acquire the trades recently. So I'll be getting to that. But that's also not going to be until later this summer. I've got a lot of work going on right now the next couple of months. So, but it's getting there. And also look for the 12 next month. That will be finished on time. And I'll do the announcement here. Right on Reads exactly what the 12 is before I reveal it online. It's been a fun project, and I'm glad it's coming to an end here, so I look forward to that. Otherwise, I'll see you around, everybody. Night.